on human targets.
Seems like a pretty clear case of self-defense.
Mike shouldn't have to die for what happened.
The way to stop him is to get inside.
Is he going to prison?
Like a nom?
The VC captured Chris, put him in a tiger cage for 10 days. They messed him up real bad. He could lose it in there.
Hold him still.
Full alert! There's a break in progress.
Dream every night. When you keep killing that poor guy, they should make you serve your time twice.
Got the rules, ain't that right?
I'm sorry, man. What did I do? I'm sorry.
Pay attention, man.
What?
Luna 2. This certified here belongs to the brothers. You got that?
Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't know. All right? Sorry.
Come on, Fish. You play with us. Don't do anything to make this man mad, Puckett. He's in here for manslaughter. Ain't that right? Killer.
Look, I really don't want any trouble. You understand?
No, I understand. $50 a week. For that, I could save you all kinds of trouble, killer. From what I hear, you better pay up fast. Word on the yard is somebody's got a contract to punch your ticket. You never know who that could be.
Visitor.
He'll be out in a minute, Mrs. Grant. On number 5.
There's been an accident.
The lawyer says that Grant's still in the prison hospital with a concussion and a broken arm. Apparently the guard got to him just in time. Couldn't identify the attacker, though.
So, brother, it's a contract hit. Revenge, you'll try again.
Danny Quick is the name of the man that Grant killed, a small-time hood. But his brother? Definitely big time. Ed Quick, loan shark drug dealer, indicted 4 times since 1987, walked on every charge. Witnesses tend to change their story right before trial. Seems like he's pretty untouchable.
So the only way to stop him is to get inside.
Inside? You mean going to prison?
Chris takes Mike Grant's place, finds the guy that Quick hired, then ties the hitman back to Quick in a way that'll stand up in court.
Okay. So what do you think? Follow.
Target's doing time. How am I supposed to get the measurement scans to make the mask and then do the voice work with you and don't suggest a house call?
Noted. Jeff.
You're in pretty deep as Grant. Once you're inside, we can't help you. And suppose you blow your cover. There are thugs and punks in there that love to get a rep by icing the human target. I think you'd be out your mind to go in.
Noted.
I spoke to Stacy Grant myself, Chris. She's young and scared and very worried about her husband. She loves him a lot. She's also gonna have a baby.
Also noted. Okay, so, case has impossible logistics, incredible risk.
And we're doing it.
Libby, contact Stacy Grant and arrange a rendezvous. Give Jeff the coordinates.
Got it.
Chris, wait a minute. You in prison?
You thinking about me in a cell?
Yeah. I'm thinking about you in a cage again, like a nom. Have you thought about that?
Yeah, I've thought about it.
And?
I'm still thinking. Jeff, not a word to the others, okay?
Okay.
I just want you to understand the danger of what we're doing. In order to protect everybody, we have to maintain complete secrecy. Now, I can't meet with your husband face to face, and my mask maker will have to rely on whatever information you can bring us.
I have videos and photos and his medical records. Is that going to be enough?
That's a good start. So I need some background information on Mike. How long have you been in prison?
3 weeks.
Charges manslaughter.
3 to 5 years.
You know, I read the court transcripts. It seems like a pretty clear case of self-defense to me. Frankly, I'm surprised he was sentenced at all. What were you two doing at Ed Quick's party?
It was just one of those stupid things. We were invited to stop by that open house by a friend of a friend. We didn't even know anybody there. The other man started it, Mr. Chance. Mike was just trying to protect me and himself. He shouldn't have hit that man. But
this is different.
It's wrong. Mike shouldn't have to die for what happened. He's a really good man, Mr. Chance. Nobody knows that better than I do. I love my husband, Mr. Chance. I love him very much.
Let's go help him.
Hey, James! Official portrait of our 15th annual 4th of July, a little bit too tipsy party.
Come on, there's got to be a close-up in here somewhere.
Stacy, put the thing away.
Mickey, right? Drop the hand. Drop the hand. The hand right
there. Hi, Mom.
That's good. That's great.
What do you think?
I think the voice isn't going to be a problem. I got plenty of clean audio track. But getting his face is going to be a stretch. Stacy, what else have you got? What's this?
He had a concussion a couple years ago. Those are the x-rays.
She's got x-rays.
Do they help?
Do they help? They're like road maps. It's all bone structure. It's great. Except we're forgetting one small detail.
What's that?
How do we get Mike out of the prison and you into it without making a lot of noise?
I got an idea. It's pretty wild. Jeff.
Right here, Chris.
Do we still have that gyroscopic navigator, the old one we just replaced?
Yes, in the hold. I've been meaning to dump it, but you know how things get around here.
Meet me down below. Call me when you're ready for mask application.
I'm shooting in the dark here, working just from pictures. This guy, he's got some tricky contours in his cheeks and in his chin.
Philo, it's gonna be fine.
All I'm saying is, I don't want you to get your hopes up.
Can we at least try it?
We can try it. I don't think it's gonna work. Look at that. It's perfect. Now, I told you not to worry.
Let's get me in the box. It's time to start my prison term.
Yeah.
Warden, that medical team from the prison board is here. They brought hardware with them. Some sort of new x-ray machine. Also, Dr. Bittinger is here.
I clear them in, Curtis, and send the doctor in.
I don't know what that team of hotshots wants with Grant. Only problem is his arm, broken radius. Matter of fact, I was about to release him.
Every time someone invents some new gizmo, the state board lets them use us as guinea pigs. Well, let's go meet them. Sign off on that waiver, and you get a few hours off.
Almost there. Are you doing okay?
Yeah. Just hurry up unless you want to hear a grown man start screaming.
I'm sorry, but we can't allow you gentlemen to come inside the way that medical liability insurance is today. I'm sure that you understand. Lucky I was able to bring my assistant.
I know, even in here I have to carry heavy malpractice.
Gentlemen, the prison board is always grateful for your cooperation. thank you very, very much.
Pleasure.
What exactly is all this about, Doc? I feel fine.
You are fine, Mike. You're just gonna have to trust us on this, okay? We're gonna explain everything to you after you wake up. Ow! It's all right. It's all right. Chris, you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just need a second. Philo?
Mike's out. Come on, let's do this. Thank God I caught you. We were just getting ready to test out the new X-ray system.
Well, how many rads are you shooting?
Rads, oh, many, many rads.
Yes, well, I've forgotten my reading glasses.
No, you'd have no need for them whatsoever if you walked in there right now. Your eyes, they were just human toast. We'll be out of your way in just a minute. Why don't you have a glass of water, and we'll be out of your way in just a minute, okay?
Thank you. I'll just...
You ready? Let's do it.
Jeff, Ed Quick is your job. You got him on 24-hour surveillance, right? That's phones, that's infrared, that's the whole deal. Philo, you assist.
Right.
Make sure that Libby does all the background checks on everybody in this joint. That's inmates and the staff. There's got to be a connection somewhere. It's got to be. Okay?
That's it. We got one more thing, though. Got your lifeline, right, boss?
No. Right.
Okay, that's it for me, Jeff. You got anything?
Yeah. Chris. Good luck, man.
It's gonna be all right.
Yeah.
It's gonna be okay.
Yeah, it's gonna be beautiful.
It's gonna be okay.
It's all right to enter, isn't it?
Yeah, we're done. Everything's fine. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Feel all right, Grant?
Yeah, I feel fine, Doctor. I felt fine before. I told them that you did a great job.
You need some help with that?
No, thank you. We're fine, really.
Hey! Woo. All right, I got it. I'm up. Come on. Hey, man.
Come on.
Okay, put it up, Solomon.
All right, here we go.
Come on. Come on.
All right,
sorry to shanghai your babysitter, but I wanted a private word.
Well, listen.
I guess you see how accidents can happen around here now, don't you?
Oh, is this your idea?
As a matter of fact, not this time. But you get my point about the protection.
Yeah, I guess so.
Well, you should have bought it $50 a week. Now you're a lousy risk. It's 75.
Okay, I'll pay you. Can you tell me who jumped me?
You still don't get the picture, do you? All you're paying for is to make sure you don't have a problem with me.
Try to get you some money.
Hey, I'm not done with you.
Break it up! Ow.
I gotta find you a safer place to play.
People, he's awake.
What is this? Where am I?
Mike, it's okay. You're safe.
Stacy.
Tapping into global overview circuits. Pointing into city grid and street coordinates. Phone line codes will identify building location. uplink to video.
Finally get a visitor. Reception. Let's see if we can get something.
Here we are, jumbo file. This must be Carlo Peroni. Look at the rap sheet on this guy. Arson, ADW, attempted murder, that's just the A's.
What are they saying? I can't hear.
You see that CIA satellite? I think that's in a good position for a link up now. Let me check the audio on that.
Well, that idiot you kicked on the inside messed up.
Chance.
Mike Brandt killed my brother here in my own home. Now I want him dead. Do you understand me?
Look, the guy, he ain't going nowhere.
That's what he thinks.
Quiet.
Let him lie awake in that cell and sweat and think about what's coming.
Yeah. Yeah. Let him wonder how he's gonna die.
Well, we'll have Libby run the data on this Carlo, you know. See where he served time, try to get a match on somebody in that prison, I don't know.
First time he didn't wake me up, one of them nightmares of yours.
Well, you know, man, you gotta fall asleep before you can have a nightmare.
Oh, I seen that look, man. That's that old 10-foot stair in the 8-foot cell.
I'll be okay.
You know what you need? You need some pleasant outdoor activity. Ain't this your lucky day?
All right. Shoot him, man. Shoot
him. Shut up and pass the ball. Come on. Hey, man, the ball.
All right, take five. Water break.
Hey, Grant, do you want to save a little wall for the rest of us? Take it easy, buddy. Want some of this?
The man drank first. Now pick it up. You want a drink, Grant? You go suck it out of the cement.
I'm not thirsty.
You know, you're a real slow learner, Grant. Maybe I just have to speed up your education.
All right.
Hey, hold on!
Hey, hold on! Hold on!
Day's been kind of dull. Why don't you let those boys have a fair fight?
Yeah!
What's this? Camera? This is going to the warden. And you, boy, gonna spend some time in the box.
Right. Ah.
Pinpointing into city grid and street coordinates. Phone line codes will identify building location.
Peek-a-boo,
locked
baby.
In.
Phone call coming in. Trace it.
Yeah?
Mr. Quick, it's Earl Lutz.
You fool, I told you not to contact me directly.
Look, I wanted to let you know it's all under control now. I got him right where I want him.
This phone call, it's not from inside the prison, it's from a private home.
What are you talking about?
Grant. They put him in solitary. Won't be anybody around. I'm going in for my shift in a couple hours, and guess what duty I pulled?
Don't call me back till it's done.
Okay, let's see if Lutz's name is on the list Libby gave us from the prison. Jeez, I don't believe this.
What?
Earl J. Lutz, the guy's a guard. Quick's hired a guard.
I don't know which is worse for Chris, that or solitary. Oh, hell. He told me not to say anything, but...
Not to say what?
The VC captured Chris. Put him in a tiger cage for 10 days. They messed him up real bad. He could lose it in there. He could lose it real bad.
A guard named Lutz? Okay, what about the omnicator?
No response. This is bad, Liv. Chris is in solitary. A killer guard, and us with no way to warn him.
Okay, maybe he's not able to respond safely, or maybe there's a malfunction.
There's no malfunction. I've checked the whole system, and we're on full power.
Could he be someplace that's shielding the signal?
No, I doubt it. Let's try maximum boost.
Got it.
Mike, what is it?
Oh, some sort of problem. I knew this wasn't going to work. Look, Stacy, we're going to have to take off.
Mike. No.
Stacy, I cannot go back to prison,
Mike,
all right?
Shh. This is insane. Where would we go?
I don't know. It doesn't matter. Just somewhere away. Just you and me, Stacy.
What about Mr. Chan?
What about him? Look, Stacy, I understand that he's just trying to help us out.
Mike, I'm scared.
Yeah, I'm scared too, Stacy.
We're on maximum power boost, and I'm still not getting anything. He's got to be at the center of the earth not to be getting this signal.
That's it. We got to spring him. And right now, Libby, plan B.
Okay, I'm not crazy about it, but I don't think we have a choice.
The plane's on the ground. There's got to be some way to get out of here.
What about the crew?
Yeah, that could be a problem. Liv.
What?
Security system. Arsenal's open.
What?
Don't move.
Hey, Mike, what are you doing?
I don't want anybody to get hurt, okay? You're just gonna have to let us off this plane.
We can't do that, Mike. Not without a direct order from Chris.
Now, I know what's happening. He's in a lot of trouble. This whole thing's just gone to hell, so just open up a door.
Okay, now. I just want you to be cool now, okay? We've got a problem here. Everything's gonna be fine. We're gonna work it all out.
Yeah, and if you don't work it out, what happens then?
Hey, there's a man in prison with your face. He put himself there for you. It's his life that's on the line.
But we're not safe.
Of course you are. If you cooperate and let us do our jobs. Come on, Mike. Give me the gun.
No.
Do you really?
really think we'd leave a loaded weapon around for you to find it?
I'm sorry.
Go on, Libby. Go on.
Yes, I need the warden right now. It's an emergency.
How you doing in there, Grant? Hey, look. Wasn't my idea to put you in there. Oz got what he asked for. He's a pig. There's not a man in here that's not happy you cleaned his clock. Tell you what. I could get busted for this, but how about I get you out of there for a couple of minutes? I know a way we won't get seen. Hey, look! You don't want to go, pal. That's fine with me.
No. No, wait. Wait a minute.
I do need to get out of here.
Okay, come on. Hey, look, just don't try anything cute either, huh?
Oh, believe me, cute's the furthest thing from my mind.
All right, let's go.
I think maybe we've gone far enough.
Relax. This may be your only time out. You should enjoy it. You smoke?
It's bad for your health.
Yeah. A lot of things are.
Can't kill me down here. They'll know it was murder.
Well, I'll break your neck down here. Drag you back, hang you in the box. They'll find you in the morning. Another poor con that cracked in solitary. Tragic.
Excuse me, Warden, but I got a woman on the phone who,
Who what, Curtis?
Well, she's pretty insistent on talking with you. Claims to have information that one of our guards, Earl Lutz, is going to kill the prisoner.
What? What prisoner?
New guy, Grant.
All the asinine. Tell her if she has a complaint or an allegation.
I've been through the standard drill with her, sir, but she's
persistent.
Line two.
All right, I'll take it.
One other thing, sir. Grant is in solitary. That's Lutz's station today.
Find Lutz. Get him up here. Bring Grant out of his cell, too. Hello, this is Warden Hudler.
Okay, Grant. See how your necktie fits. You got fight left in you, huh, smart boy?
Somehow, I tracked him here. Uh-oh. Get this creep out of here, Snyder. I'm gonna go see the doc. Tell the warden I'll be here as soon as I can.
You can't let that man leave. You gotta let me talk to the warden.
Shut up and move.
You gotta have to let me talk to the warden.
I have a right to talk to the warden. That man tried to kill me. Don't let him leave. Let me talk to the warden.
This better be good.
I'm going to explain everything.
I'd prefer that we were alone.
Yeah, right. Look, I am going to do nothing except stand here and talk. You can keep the cuffs on me. You can keep your men close.
Give me the baton.
We'll be right outside, sir.
Hey.
Hey.
Hey! Sweet Mother Mary.
We're starting to break down anyway.
Look here, mister.
Chance, Chris Chance.
Whoever you are, you better start doing some of that talking you promised right now. Where's my prisoner?
He's safe, I assure you. Look, I'm sorry for the...
Sorry? Mister, you will be sorry. Do you know what it means to illegally remove a prisoner from a state correctional institution?
Look, let me put your mind at ease on one thing at a time. May I?
Chris, hey, Chris. Man, am I glad to see
oh,
you.
Oh, boy, we were worried.
Put Mike on, Libby.
You got it, Chris. He's right here.
He's where? On our plane. Look, there's a number I can give you to call in Washington, D.C. The people there know about me. They can tell you about me and how I work. But for now...
For now, you're in more trouble than you could possibly imagine.
And I have company.
What's that supposed to mean?
You got a missing prisoner, warden. Somebody walked in and snagged him. How's that look? Then I can assure you, Officer Lutz is not in the infirmary. He's long gone by now. No security, dirty guards, murder for hire. Your record's not looking too good.
Fine. I'll call your number in Washington. Count on it. That'll only be one of a lot of calls I'm going to make. And until I sort this out, you're going to fill that empty cell I suddenly have in C block.
I wish we didn't have to do it this way.
Hey, Chris. Remember Lombai?
What's he talking about?
Like it was yesterday.
About 5 minutes.
Better make it four.
Progress.
Much longer.
I'm not making microwave popcorn here, Chris. Perfection takes time.
Come on, give me an estimate.
It'll be like 15 more minutes.
Okay, let me know. Anything new on Lutz?
Oh, Jeff is still trailing him. He's scheduled to arrive at Quick's house in about an hour to explain what went wrong.
You think they're ready to talk yet?
Only one way to find out. Oh, something else, by the way. I was examining the court records, and guess what? The judge who let Quick off the hook the last time he was indicted just happens to be the same judge that sent Mike to prison. I smell a rat.
Yeah, a rat with a gavel.
Yeah.
Keep the surveillance satellites on Ned Quick's place. I want to know what's happening, okay?
You got it.
Pretty dumb move.
Yeah, maybe. Maybe yours was, too. In fact, this whole idea never really had a prayer of a chance in the first place, did it?
And your running away did?
Yes.
Yeah? Run far enough and long enough, and maybe you'll beat Ed Quick in the end? Is that what you think? You're a convict, Mike. You've escaped from prison. Is that the life you want for both of you? For your baby?
least it's a chance.
Your best chance is still with us.
Then do it. Find Ed quick and kill him. I don't care anymore. Just kill him before he kills my husband.
That's not what I do. I want to save a life, not take one.
Now, it doesn't much matter, does it? I mean, I'm a prisoner either way, here or there.
Not for long. We'll make our move today.
How?
You escaped from prison, Mike. No reason why you shouldn't be able to get out of here.
Time getting here.
I gotta be careful. People might be following me.
You sure can't screw up a job, Lutz.
I can still get them.
Not just how are you gonna do that?
I still got plenty of friends inside. I can pay these guys.
Enough of this crap. What's the matter with you, Lutz? Don't you listen to the radio? Huh? Mike Grant escaped from prison. And now I have to track him on the run. And I don't like that. You understand what I'm saying to you? Huh?
Chris, things are heating up. You better head out.
Okay. Well, we sure wouldn't want anything to happen to Officer Lutz now, would we?
Right.
I'm in. Is the camera working okay?
It's perfect.
Who in the hell is that?
Not gonna believe this. It's Grant.
Bring him in here. This might be your lucky day, Earl.
Jeff, it's a go, so stand by.
Oh, man, I love my job.
Social call, Grant.
Look, the reason I'm here is because I just want this to end, all right? I brought money.
You're gonna buy me off? You kill my brother and then offer me money?
We both know that that was an accident.
Yeah, well, I took care of
that accident part. That judge cost me plenty. And I would have had you whacked in prison if this fool hadn't missed.
That'll stand up in court, huh?
Yep. Now let's just make sure we can keep Chris standing.
Carlo, Lutz.
Wait a minute. You can't kill me. My wife, she's...
Show Mr. Grant our beautiful view. I want him to see what my brother saw when he pushed him through the window.
Jeff, listen, Lutz and the Renovies have got Chris directly in front of the window. I want you to wait for my signal.
I'm with it. He's wired!
Yeah, but what else have we got here? Hold him still.
Okay, now.
Behind
you. I made that call to Washington, you know. You have some interesting friends.
Well, I'm sorry I didn't have time to explain it in your office.
You were persuasive enough. I still don't know whether to prosecute you or to thank you.
Do I get a vote?
It's amazing how many witnesses came forward from Ed Quick's party once he was arrested.
You know, I still can't believe it. He actually bribed a judge to override my self-defense appeal.
The new hearing is 3 weeks from now.
Well, you're a free man, Michael.
Yes, thank you.
And I just want to thank you from all three of us.
Oh, we have a surprise. We have decided to name the baby in your honor.
You gonna name him Chris?
No, we're gonna name her Libby.
I hereby sentence you to life imprisonment.
Next on Human Target.
Do you know this man?
All my life.
Coming in town one day and I'm right back where I was 20 years ago. What do you want from me, Dad?
I'm not saying that your dad is the easiest guy to get along with.
You noticed.
He's my son. And I love him a lot.
When was the last time you said that?
Dad?
I'm David Brinkley. On our This Week program Sunday, only one guest, President Bush. He says yes, he's made mistakes. Now, can he catch up? Can he win? How? Sunday.
Stay tuned for The Commish, next.